Friends, today in this video, I'm going to discuss you about diastereomers. Diastereomers are a stereoisomer which are not mirror image to each other. For diastereomer, there is one very most important point is that the number of asymmetric centers should be greater than one. So, as shown in this example, you can see the number of asymmetric center is more than one in both the molecule. So this is the first condition for diastereomers, that the asymmetric center or a chiral center in a particular molecule will be greater than one. And second condition is that if you'll do its like RS nomenclature, then you'll find that at carbon center 1 there is S, carbon center 2 there is R. So S and R. But in its diastereomer, the carbon center 1 is having S configuration and second carbon center, it is having S configuration. So this is another very important point about diastereomer, is that one is having common configuration at a particular asymmetric center, but another one will definitely will have a different configuration. So these are the two important points about diastereomers. And you can easily remember this, that for a molecule to be a diastereomer, the atom will be same, its molecular formula will be same, connectivity will be same, but the orientation will be different. So as you can see in this example only, all the atoms are same, molecular formula, everything is same, but at the center the orientation of this bromine and proton is different, whereas in this molecule the orientation of proton and bromine is different. So this is the simple trick to remember about diastereomers. Two points to remember about diastereomer is that one is having more than one asymmetric center or a chiral center, and another is that the configuration, that is R or S, will be for one center there will be a same configuration, another center will be different configuration. Now I'll talk about its property. As I have discussed in my previous video about enantiomers, what is enantiomers and what are its physical, chemical, spectral property. Similarly, I will discuss diastereomers' physical, chemical and spectral properties. So physical properties, first of all, physical properties. So physical properties, which I already mentioned, that like melting point, boiling point, refractive index, etc. So for all the physical properties of diastereomers will be different, whether the difference will be small or large, but the physical properties, all physical properties for a diastereomers will be different. Okay, now its chemical properties. The chemical properties of diastereomers will be different in chiral as well as a chiral medium. In case of enantiomer, you have seen that the chemical properties of enantiomers in a chiral medium is always same, but here in this diastereomer case, the chemical properties for chiral and achiral medium mein jo hote hain wo sare different honge, theek hai. And I'll just for chiral or achiral medium it will be different. Then spectral property NMR, IR, UV, etc., mass, HPLC, etc. So diastereomer will have different property. So this is very short and precise video about diastereomers. If you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.